Okay, so let's continue. I'm gonna copy this, paste it over here, and we have a lot of groups here, so let's see. Let's start with don't have bricks. Okay, so there's that. I should definitely have cleaned this up, but it's okay for now. I'm gonna call this Windows Concrete. Nothing there. Windows Corners. Even though it's not really a corner, but yeah, it's fine. Okay, so ground middle. None of that stuff. Concrete top, yep. I'm gonna color this with green so I know what to add to it later. So this guy, something is wrong with this guy. So let's mark this red. And top windows. I think I saw those, yeah. Yeah, we had a group for that. All left, okay. So this guy's with the green stuff. Wall middle. Okay, glass. We don't need that for now, but I'll separate it and mark it. Then nothing. Yeah, I'm gonna delete these. I'm not gonna use them. I simplified the model. Outside, I don't need that. I don't need that too. Windows, yep. So I need these guys. Windows top base. No wood here. Level one. Okay, so let's call these windows wood top. And let's give it this color. And this is gonna give a blue, and this we're going to fix. And what I'm going to do is, I think looking at this, it looks like there's an issue with the mesh somewhere, or this group I don't need anyway, but it feels like there, yeah, something is wrong with this mesh for sure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this guy, hit delete, and I'm going to blast this. Gonna blast this guy. Sorry, not this. This block, and delete non-selected. So this block is better, it's cleaner, and I removed the messed up block. I'm gonna put down a transform node and template this. I'm gonna move it so that it's on top of that. I'm gonna merge it with the clean geo, so now I have a clean mesh and this guy I don't need anymore. These three we're going to merge together. for the bricks. I am still tempted. Okay, we'll do some fracturing here. But I don't think we have to do that. And let's copy this guy. And let's remove this. Let's delete this. Okay, so center ID 1. Okay, so we need more pieces. 30, 60 more. And let's set this to 0.1. This is the first level, so the jitter doesn't do much, and I'm fine with this for now. Okay, so what else do we have? These guys, let's try. Let's put down a fracture node, and definitely not 260. I'm gonna set this to 10. And I'm not gonna visualize it using the center ID. I'm gonna visualize it using an assemble node, and I will explain in a second why. So we have an assemble somewhere with a color node, I believe. No. Okay. So let's put down a color node. The reason I use this because we want to visualize these unique pieces and then whatever fracture happened to them. So it looks like it's working. Let's increase the fracture so it's quite chaotic between the pieces. And we're getting some chipping here. So something like this. I don't want to mess it too much. Just separate a few pieces. Okay, so that's done. And these guys, let's copy this. And let's try 20. Let's visualize the center ID. And these guys, I don't want to fracture in too many pieces for sure. I want to keep them blocky. Yeah, something like that. Because later we're going to add the up-res, and it would be really cool to get these blocks to separate and start crumbling. And let's lower this to 0.3. I don't want too much. No, I like that. And this is cool. Okay, so that's done. And then these guys, I'll copy here. As you can see, I'm not doing the layered fracturing on everything. Just when I need it. And again, same trick. We need to view this using the name. Yeah, definitely. This is looking pretty cool. We don't have to randomize each one of them. I mean, we can to avoid things like, getting uniform pattern or a continuous pattern. We can definitely break that. But I think it's okay for now. So these guys, let's copy which one? Let's copy the one from the big blocks. So this. Yep, pretty cool. Maybe here is too much. I'm getting some issues there. So let's try 0.02. Set this to 0.1. Looking good. And let's see, this guy, yeah, this guy, I think I'm gonna do multiple layers. I'm gonna do two layers for sure. Okay, let's just set this to 30. And I'm not liking the stretched pattern, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to scale this along the z-axis, maybe 0.5, and then scale it, make it bigger, and let's try scale it back and see how that looks. It's different than this for sure. I like this better. Let's set it to 40. And I think I'm going to remesh this. So let's group. Let's try and group the hard edges of this geometry. Not those. That's it. I need that group, and let's remesh it. And let's set this to 1 for now. And let's delete all the groups. I should have done this with all the other stuff. And group 1. Okay. Point 1. 0.04, too much, 0.06, okay. And let's take a look here. And let's lower the amplitude. Okay, let's copy this and do a secondary fracture. And I like this pattern now. Definitely. Let's change the seed. Maybe increase this to 60. Yep, perfect. And let's use a color node and see how that looks. That's center ID 1. Center ID, yep, this is really cool. Okay. And then this we're gonna do later. We're not gonna worry about any of this for now. And I think that's pretty much it. I'm going to merge all these guys. And that's our fractured geo. And this is gonna take some time to compute, so what I'm going to do is I'm gonna cache each section to disk, and then we'll continue in the next video. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in a bit.